Fine. All right. Look, guys, we will have a good conversation today. We have Dr. Rohi. He is on air. Let us call him. Hello.
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum, Dr. Rohi. How are you?
Alaikum salam. How are you?
I'm fine. Good to have you, my friend. How is everything? I hope that your health and the family is good.
Alhamdulillah, all good. Long time, no see you.
Well, Dr. Rohi, I'm here. All what you need to do, just let me know, because you know I don't go really in pal talk. Unless I don't go in pal talk at all, actually. I do only in Skype and YouTube, you know. So like I just saw your message you sent to me, but I did not go in pal talk for a long time. But anyway, this is the program we do here, you know, the time. You just call me, you can call me in Skype. Try to download Skype and add my name there. I can text it to you, or Rina, she can text it to you, and you can call me in Skype anytime you wish. Anyway, Dr. Rohi, we were talking to the people here about how Muhammad, he became a prophet in Islam. Like the story about him in the cave of Hira. Can you tell us what happened exactly? If you don't mind.
Yes.
Okay.
Just a minute. Also. Muhammad, God is sent Jibril to him in the cave and tell him to that he a prophet and said, read, and your Lord is the most generous, who taught by the being taught man that which he knew not. This is the beginning of the prophet.
I don't know, you are saying something to me, I cannot really find it in the story, because there's nowhere in the hadith it says that the angel, he said to Muhammad, you are a prophet. Do you agree? You just say,
no,
you say that the angel told him you are a prophet, but nowhere he said that to him. Where he said to him you are a prophet?
In the hadith said, I am Jibril and you are a prophet.
In the hadith it says that? Which hadith is that? Can you read it for us, please, if you don't mind?
Yes, I search about hadith. Search what, let's see. There is a hadith said, I am Jibril and you are the prophet of Allah.
So the hadith which is coming from the report of Khadija, where she said to him that when he came back and he told her, cover me, and she took him to Waraqa. And then Waraqa is the one who told him that this is Jibril. Which story is the correct one?
In hadith said, do you read in Sunnah's box? And hadith said that Jibril said, I am Jibril. This is what the ignorant Arab Christian always says, and you believe it.
No, my friend, you have to prove it to me. I have the hadith in front of me, Dr. Rohi. With my respect to you, I have the
prophet,
hadith in front of
prophet me. Muhammad said, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I entered Khadija's house, then I said, cover me until fear went away from me. Then Jibril came to me and said, I am Jibril and you are messenger of Allah. This is hadith is narrated by Ibn
Ishaq. If you don't mind, what is the hadith number you are talking about? Is it in Sahih al-Bukhari?
This hadith in Kitab A'lam al-Nubuwwa lil-Mawardi.
Which one is the correct hadith? The one in Sahih al-Bukhari or the one in the Mawardi?
No. Yes, there is another hadith, not all hadith in Bukhari, but in other books, there is
I understand,
correct
because,
hadith.
but now,
There,
you see, what I'm trying to say to you, Dr. Rohi, that one of them have to be lying. It can't be the true stories are correct, because one is saying he did not say to him anything about, I'm an angel, and you are a prophet. And the other one you are saying, it says he is an angel, and he told him, you are a prophet. So which one of those stories is a lie? The one in Sahih al-Bukhari or the one in the book of al-Mawardi?
In this book, let me read this hadith to know what the nass of this hadith. So يقول ثم دخلت على خديجة فقلت زملوني زملوني حتى ذهبت عني ثم أتاني فقال يا محمد أنا جبريل وأنت رسول الله صلى الله وأنت رسول الله ثم قال اقرأ قلت ما أقرأ قال فأخذني فغتني ثلاث مرات حتى بني الجهد وقال اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق فأتيت خديجة فقلت لقد أشفقت على نفسي فأخبرتها خبري فقالت أبشر فوالله لا يخزيك الله أبدا هذا في كتاب أعلام النبوة للموردي
Okay.
حديث الذي
Is it a صحيح حديث؟
Yes, this is a صحيح حديث.
Okay. And what about the one in front of me? Is it Sahih Hadith? The one in Sahih al-Bukhari. The one in Sahih al-Bukhari. Hadith number 3. The book number 1. Hadith number 3. Which one of them is a true story? Because if that one is Sahih.
Yes.
And this one is Sahih.
What said this Hadith that with you?
This one never mentioned anything that the angel, it says everything the angel said to him and never mentioned to him that I am an angel and you are a messenger of Allah. He never said to him. The one who said to him, who is this angel? It was Waraqa. Muhammad was taken by Khadija to his wife, by Khadija, his wife, to Waraqa ibn Nawfal. And Waraqa ibn Nawfal is the one who told him this, told him that this is must be, he is just guessing, must be the angel who come to the prophet before you, and this is Jibreel. It was not Jibreel who told him that. So which one of them is a true story? One of them have to be a lie. It can't be both. Read to me. It says Waraqa, he said to him, oh my nephew, what have you been, what have you seen, what have you seen?
My friend, this hadith that was you from Bukhari not conflict with this hadith that
no,
I
it
read,
does not, it does not, because here, no, my friend, the one is saying, the one who said to Muhammad that this is Jibreel, the angel, it was Waraqa. Muhammad never said in the whole hadith that this is an angel, and never said that the angel told me you are a prophet. So there's a big conflict. Muhammad, he have no idea what's happening, he do not know what this guy is about, and Waraqa is the one who told him this is must be Jibreel. Look,
no,
what Waraqa
no,
said to him. Look what Waraqa said to him. This is the same one who keeps the secret between two brackets, Jibreel, whom Allah had sent to Moses. This is what it says in the story. So in the hadith here, there's a big contradiction for the story you are telling me. Okay, let us say your story you told me is true, that the angel told him, I am Jibreel and you are a messenger of Allah. Why Muhammad was scared and terrified, and then he needed to be taken to Waraqa, and Waraqa told him again, this must be Jibreel. Why Muhammad is so scared and terrified, and he need to be covered, and he have a fever. What's happened exactly? I mean, do you get fear when you see an angel of God?
Yes, it is the first once that he connect with Jibreel, with this big angel, and he...
How big he is? What do you mean big angel?
What
do you mean big angel? Is he big?
Yes, Jibreel is the big angel that...
How he was
Allah
able to enter
in
inside
the
cave then, if he is so big? How he big, and then he is inside the cave, as we know that a man, he came to him, not an angel. The one who
yes,
came to Muhammad, did
he
came to him as a man or he came to him as an angel?
He came to him as an angel and not as a man.
Not
in
as a man.
This moment, not. No, no, yes, not.
Okay.
But not as an angel in the original picture in the but he came here to Muhammad in the simple picture to send yani to tell him that
so angels they can change their look in Islam.
Yes, maybe.
No, maybe or yes. Maybe or yes. Yes. Okay, yes. Okay.
Maybe he right. Change.
So angel he can change his shape. Why he can change his shape? And why he need to change his shape? Can he come as a human?
Yes, he come to human.
Why?
And do you know that why? That angel came to Mary, that angel came to Abraham, they came to Lot.
No, the angel came to Mary. The one came to Mary in the Quran doesn't say it's an angel. It says that Allah he sent his spirit and the spirit appeared as a perfect man. Doesn't say as an angel.
Yes, but the Holy Spirit in the Islam is Jibreel.
There's nowhere in the Quran it says that the Holy Spirit is Jibreel. Not even a single verse.
They said in the Quran, قُلْ نَزَّلَهُ رُوحُ الْقُدُسِ عَلَى قَلْبِكَ بِالْحَقِّ
روح القدس.
نَزَّلَهُ رُوحُ الْقُدُسِ
Right, روح القدس.
نعم, وروح القدس okay. روح القدس in Islam
what أو القدس
التفسير هو جبريل.
Dr. Rohi,
نزل به
What the word قدس mean?
روح القدس
What the word قدس mean? قدس روح القدس روح is a spirit قدس what قدس mean?
Yes the spirit is divided into two parts, the Holy Spirit and the unclean spirit. In other words, the spirit of the truth and the spirit of error.
Okay, so there is a Holy Spirit in Islam, and it is holy because it's holy or because it's just a title? Is it holy, really holy, the spirit?
Yes,
okay.
Holy.
So now you have a holy God and you have a Holy Spirit and you have a holy angel.
Who have me and
you because you are saying for me Holy Spirit is God, for you Holy Spirit is an angel. So now he is an angel but he is holy. I thought only God is holy. So you Muslims now have two holy, as you are saying. You have a holy spirit, holy Jibreel and holy Allah.
No my friend. Holy Spirit is the holy revelation that descends on the prophets. This makes them full of movement and activity. And
my friend, what holy movement?
Divine message.
Doctor, listen. And is the Holy Spirit a Jibreel or not? You said it is Jibreel. Now you are saying it's inspiration. Is it inspiration or it's a person? Is the Holy Spirit inspiration or it's a person?
Inspiration.
Inspiration, so it's not Jibreel. So it's not Jibreel.
We don't know what is Jibreel in the true picture.
My friend,
we are imaging Angel Jibreel, but who is Jibreel? How is Jibreel? We don't know.
Guys, listen to this. Dr. Rohi just said to us, who is Jibreel? What is the Jibreel? We do not know. And he cannot confirm to us if Jibreel is the Holy Spirit or not. A second ago he said Jibreel is the Holy Spirit, and now he is saying the Holy Spirit is not Jibreel. It is inspiration. I mean, how confusing this religion is, because you do not know. You are a person who have a PhD in Islam, and yet you cannot confirm to us if the Holy Spirit is Jibreel himself. And you said in the beginning it is Jibreel, and then you took it back. You
yes.
say no, it is inspiration.
Yes.
Jibreel
yes.
is an inspiration. Is he Jibreel? Is the Holy? Let us make it clear. Is the Holy Spirit an angel or it is an inspiration? Confirm that to me.
The Holy Spirit is descends by Jibreel, but
the Holy Spirit is sent by Jibreel. A second ago you told me that the Holy Spirit is Jibreel.
Yes, but listen to me. As to the non-prophets, ordinary people, they filled by the spirit that provides them with the thoughts that is useful to them in the affairs of their lives. But if he was a trader, so for example, if he was a trader or owner of company, he will fill by useful idea in developing his company and increasing his business. And this person was, for example, a writer or author, this spirit will provide him with the creativity that will make him write a story, for example, and he will watch for these stories and he will suffer poverty, fatigue, and staying up at night to write a story or novel, for example. Therefore, from the mercy of God to his servants, he gives even his share of this spirit. God say in Quran, what say the God is to all these and those we extend from the gifts of your Lord. The gifts of your Lord are not restricted. So in the Bible, what said the Bible?
Dr. Rohi, not respect to you, my friend.
Listen,
what you are saying to me,
me
have nothing to do with my question. Have nothing to do with my
friend,
question. Is Jibreel the Holy Spirit? Either you say, you confirm to me, find an answer. Either you say Jibreel is the Holy Spirit, or you say he is not the Holy Spirit. Give me an answer. Is he the Holy Spirit, or he is not the Holy Spirit?
The Holy Spirit is come down by Jibreel.
So,
but
the Holy Spirit is not Jibreel. Is that correct?
But Quran said,
no,
نزله روح القدس. نزله روح القدس.
One by one.
القرآن يؤكد أنه.
Dr. Rohi, just one by one. Confirm and say clearly that the Holy Spirit is not Jibreel. Just make it clear, please. So people, they will listen in, they will listen, they will hear you. Say clearly, I believe, I'm a Muslim, Dr. Rohi, that the Holy Spirit is not Jibreel. Jibreel is a different person. Say it, please. Go ahead.
Look, I confirm that the Holy Spirit is come down by Jibreel.
What by Jibreel? What is that by Jibreel? What is that by Jibreel? I'm asking you, is Jibreel the Holy Spirit or not? This is not my question. I'm not asking you how the Holy Spirit came down by the elevator, came down by Jibreel. This is not the question.
Yes, he is the
Holy Spirit, or he is not the Holy Spirit? Is Jibreel the Holy Spirit, or the Holy Spirit is a different person? I'm listening.
He is the Holy Spirit.
He is the Holy Spirit.
Who,
so how you say,
yes,
the Holy Spirit came down by Jibreel if he is not the Holy Spirit? A second ago you said he is not the Holy Spirit. Just a second ago.
I mean that he give people Holy Spirit.
What do you mean he give people?
Holy
is
Spirit.
He the Holy Spirit, or he give people Holy Spirit? Is he? If he is Holy Spirit, he give himself to the people?
The all Holy Spirit.
Okay,
that,
let me ask you: is the angels in Islam are they? Is the angels in Islam
from
are they spirit?
From Jibreel.
Is the angels in Islam are they spirit?
Yes.
They are
a
spirit. Can you confirm that to me in the Quran? Because the Quran says the opposite. The Quran says al malaika wal ruh, al malaika wal ruh. The angels and the spirit. So the Quran confirm that al ruh is not the angels. So where do you get this from?
What said in Quran? ما هو بروح القدس؟ التفسير تقول روح القدس هو جبريل في عند يقول وأيدناه بروح القدس أين يقول أيضا كثير من الآيات أو مثلا قل نزله روح القدس من ربك بالحق.
If people go from the beginning, they will hear you. You repeat it many times, saying you confirm many times that Jibreel is not the Holy Spirit. Now you take it back, and you say Jibreel is the Holy Spirit. Now we go back to zero. In the Quran, chapter 70, verse number 4, it says, "Tu'arriju al-mala'ikatu wal-ruh ilayhi," the angels and the spirit. So if the angels are the spirit, then Allah should not say the angels and the spirit, they will descend it to him, descend it to him. So you obviously have no backup to say to me where you get this from, that Jibreel is the Holy Spirit, and then you say that Jibreel is not the Holy Spirit, and then you change your mind and you said no, Jibreel is the Holy Spirit, and then you said to me that Jibreel come down with the Holy Spirit. How he come down with the Holy Spirit if he is the Holy Spirit? I will tell you why, because you yourself have no idea what to answer, and you are the one who said to me, we Muslims, we do not know who is Jibreel, how he is Jibreel. Is that correct? You said that. So now you do not know if he is a spirit, or what you are saying to me, that maybe he is the Holy Spirit. Maybe he came down with the Holy Spirit. Maybe he bring down the Holy Spirit. Maybe he give the other people the Holy Spirit. But is Jibreel the Holy Spirit? Sometimes you say yes. Sometimes you say no. Sometimes he says he is the other person. In the same conversation, you give me many answers. Which one we will take?
In the tafsir, for example, for verse that said تعرج الملائكة والروح إليه. The tafsir said angel and Jibril.
The angels and Jibril. Why Jibril is not an angel? Is Jibril is different kind of angels? Is Jibril is different kind of angels? When you say the angels and the spirit scanned into him, and you are saying to me that the tafsir says it means the angels and Jibril. Since when Jibril became a spirit and the angels are not a spirit? Is the angels are not spirit? Like, is Mikael not spirit? Is Israel not spirit in Islam? Is Israfil is not a spirit? Only Jibril is a spirit and the rest are not?
Yes, who what Islam, is this Jibril? There is a special place in because he is sent to the prophet. He take them.
Which prophet Jibril he was sent to? Which prophet he was sent to? Name one for me.
All the prophets.
Where?
All the prophets.
Give me a story. Give me the story. When Jibril came to a prophet in the Quran, who?
To us, to Isa.
Where it says that he, you know, he came.
وأيدناه وعندما قال وأيدناه بروح القدس.
Yes, وأيدناه. Yes, we support him with the Holy Spirit. Doesn't saying that we send him the Holy Spirit. We supported him, which means the Holy Spirit support him always, no problem. But doesn't say that Allah he sent him as a messenger to him. Who is the messenger? He received a message from the Holy Spirit in the Quran.
And the Holy Spirit come also to Abraham.
Where?
When he
where
teaching him by his son.
Where? Which verse?
In Quran, not clear this, but in Hadith.
So those stories are just the fiction stories which Muslims they add later to cover something missing in the Quran. The Quran says that Allah he sent the Holy Spirit to prophets, but we cannot find one prophet. Allah he sent him the Holy Spirit. So what we do, we create stories and we say, oh, those are not in the Quran, those are in the stories we made. In the Quran, my friend, that it says that Abraham, he became a star worshipper. Is that correct? He was a star worshipper.
What a star?
Yes, he worshipped the stars.
No, not he worshipped the stars. In Quran, not.
Are you sure?
Where this ayat said?
Okay, guys, Dr. Rohi, he have a PhD in Islam, and he's saying there's nowhere in the Quran it says that Abraham, he worshipped stars. Okay, let us go and see if Abraham, he did that or not. And we will read together. فَلَمَّا رَأَى الشَّمْسَ بَازِغَةً قَالَ هَذَا رَبِّي هَذَا أَكْبَرُ Chapter 6, verse number 78. When he saw the stars, when he saw the sun, he said, this is my God, this is Akbar. And you just said that there is nowhere in the Quran it says that Abraham, he worshipped stars. And we can read actually from verse number 76, 77, 78, you will see that Abraham in Islam is nothing but a pagan man who worshipped stars and planets. And you are a person with PhD and you confirm to me that there is nowhere in the Quran it says so. How come? Something missing here.
This is when Abraham was a boy, a little boy. So what,
my friend, what a boy? What you said, okay? Well, hold on. I ask you, did Abraham worship the stars? You said to me no, and you said nowhere in the Quran.
Yes,
look,
my friend. I will read the ayah that you. سيد فلما رأى الشمس بازغة قال هذا ربي هذا أكبر فلما أفلت قال يا قوم إني بريء مما تشركون and when he saw the sun rising he said this is my Lord this is a greater but when it set he said oh my people indeed I am free from what you associate with Allah
how Abraham he learned about worship. Allah. How Abraham, who a second ago was worshipping the stars and the suns and the moon, and he called them Akbar, which is very weird. Now, suddenly he became a believer in Allah. How he knew about Allah?
Yes, but in this before this ayah, what he said? فَلَمَّا رَأَى الْقَمَرَ بَازِغًا قَالَ هَذَا رَبِّي فَلَمَّا أَفَلَ قَالَ لَئِن لَّمْ يَهْدِنِي رَبِّي لَأَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْقَوْمِ الضَّالِّينَ And when he saw the moon raising, he He said, this is my Lord. When it said, he said, unless my Lord guide me, I will surely be among the people gone astray.
Okay, and then his Lord guide him and made him worship the sun, because after that he started worshiping the sun.
No, but his Lord guide to him. So
no, he guided him. See what happened next, my friend. He will go. His Lord guide him, unless my Lord guide me. The verse after it says, verse number 78, when he saw the sun rising in splendor, he said, this is my Lord, this is the greatest, this is Akbar, and he started worshiping the sun. So his Lord guide him to worship the sun?
No, it is what the beginning of ayah in this story said. Look, see my friend.
Mm-hmm.
See, I read. وكذلك نري إبراهيم ملكوت السماوات والأرض ولا يكون من الموقنين. And thus did we show Abraham the realm of the heavens and the earth, that he would be among the certain in faith. And then what said? فلما جن عليه الليل رأى كوكبا قال هذا ربي فلما أفل قال لا أحب الآفلين. So when the night covered him with a darkness, he saw a star. He said, this is my Lord. But when it set, he said, I like not those that disappear.
Okay, let us go by the logic once, Dr. Rohi. Abraham, he saw a star, as you said. In the beginning, you told me Abraham who know where he worshiped stars. Well, now we found that he worshiped many stars, and he was a star worshiper. He's a Sabian. Simply, he's a Sabian. And this is what the Sabians do. So now, Abraham, as a Sabian, worshiping star, he saw a star in the sky, as you said, and then he said, this is my Lord. Then he decided not to believe in this star because this star disappeared. Do you really believe in this story? Why now Abraham decided not to believe in the star because he disappeared? What does that mean exactly? Explain to us.
Abraham, Allah told us that Abraham was a logical, have a logical mind when he small baby. So the Quran told us how he development in mind and how he development in the faith that he reached to God. So the Quran told us how this is.
Yeah, but I'm saying, my friend, I understand. What I'm saying is, don't you see there's a mistake in this verse in the Quran? Because why Abraham decided not to believe in this star no more? According to the Quran, what is the reason he decided not to believe in that star? What is the reason?
this is the thinking of boy.
No. Why, my friend?
Maybe he was 6 years.
No, okay, my friend. Don't say this is 6 years. This guy, he was a man. He destroyed the idols then. I mean, what are you talking about? What is 6 years? You made him 6 years now? And where do you get this 6 years from? Do you have like a backup for it? 6 years when this happened to him? Come on. Now listen, I love not those who that sit. Okay, so the reason for him, he don't want to worship the star because this star disappeared. Is that correct? It says there in front of me, the reason for him, he decided to leave worshiping the star is what? Because the star set, the star disappeared. Correct?
Yes.
All right. But this means Abraham, he never saw a star before and he never noticed that it disappeared. That's crazy. Because all of us, we knew that stars don't stay there. Even the sun doesn't stay there. Even the moon doesn't stay there. So this has happened as if Abraham, he was in a cave and he never saw the sun, the moon, the stars, the sky ever before. And then we opened the door for him and then he went out and suddenly he see a star. He said, this is my God. And then the star disappeared and that's it. He said, okay, you know what? This star disappeared. I don't believe in him because I don't believe in that. That doesn't make sense. That means Abraham, he never saw a star before. Don't Abraham, he knew that the stars disappear and they appear again and disappear again. So what is the logic of this verse?
That this 419 one night.
What one night? What one night, my friend? My friend, what one night? Are you saying to me that here Abraham, he worshipped the stars for one night, and this is the first night ever in his life he noticed that the stars disappear?
The Quran not say that he worshipped it.
It says he worshipped it. What are you talking about?
This is my Lord.
Rohi, when you say this is my God, if I say that Jesus is my God, obviously I worship him. Don't you agree? Come on. Don't tell me he did not worship him. He said, this is my Lord. This is my God. Haza Rabbi. And then when this star disappeared, he said, I'm not going to worship a star which disappear. But this is funny because that means Abraham, he never saw a star before. And he never noticed that the stars disappear. And then he worshiped the moon. Okay, hold on. The star disappeared, the moon appeared. So now Abraham, and you said to me, maybe this is one night. And then the moon appeared. Okay, the moon will stay in the sky for a long time. Now, when the moon disappeared, he said to himself, I will not certainly worship the ones who would go astray. Okay, so now he do the same again, same game. The moon appeared. He liked the moon. This is my God. Okay, I will worship the moon. But this is mean, Abraham, he never saw the moon before. And then Abraham decided to leave the moon. And then he saw the sun. He looked at the sun, he says, wow, this is my God. This is Akbar. Even he called him Akbar, Allahu Akbar. So he say, when he saw the sun rising in splendor, he said, this is my God, this is Akbar. And then he started worshiping the sun. But when the sun set, he said, oh my people, I am indeed free from your guilt of giving partners to Allah. Look what? Suddenly he knows about Allah, and suddenly he don't want to worship the sun, and the name of Allah did appear. Where did he get the name of Allah from?
So he yani worship or said, this is my Lord for night and day, when he saw the moon and the
Have you ever heard of somebody change his religion every 10 minutes? I mean, what's wrong with this guy? He saw the stars and the stars disappear. Then the second night, let's say every night he changed. Then the second night he saw the moon. Okay, between the night before and the night after, didn't he see the sun? What happened to the sun? You see the sun, according to the story, the sun he saw at the end. So based in the story in the Quran, Abraham, he saw the stars, he saw the moon, and all this time he did not see the sun yet. It looked like the sun took a vacation. Night after night, stars come, moon come and go, and then the sun come. What does that mean? There's something fishy in this story, because if the first night the stars goes, it's mean the sun came. This is how the stars disappear. So, but in the story here, the stars goes and the moon come. And then the moon goes and then the sun come. How this happen? And because they come and go, I'm not going to believe in them? Did Abraham see Allah anyway? If he believed not in the one who cannot be seen, the one who go astray, he never saw Allah. So how he can believe in Allah, and how Allah introduced himself to Abraham? What is the angel you spoke of?
The first ayah that said falamma janna alayhi al-layl. Then this story is first begin in the night when he
understand.
So when
for
the
sure
night
tonight,
covered
for sure.
Him
for sure it's in the night, because he cannot see the stars in the daytime usually. So the night came. He believed in the star, okay, and then the star went away. That's mean the sun came again, and then the moon came back. That's mean second day at least, okay. How come Abraham did not worship the sun when he saw the sun second day after the star left before the moon come? Because according to the order here, you will see that he saw a star,
yes,
and he decided to worship the star. Yeah. He said,
This is my Lord.
Okay,
this is a greater.
Okay, no problem. The star is gone. Why the star he don't want to worship in nor? Because he's gone. Okay, that's mean a new day came. That's mean the sun appeared. How come Abraham did not worship the sun after he saw the star? Where is the
yes,
what is
that?
This?
I said that is a night and day only.
Okay. Let us go deep. Abraham, he spoke suddenly about Allah. How he learned about Allah? Did Jibreel came to him, you think?
Yes, Jibreel came,
but, as a man or as what?
The Quran not mentioned that how the Jibreel come to Abraham,
where it mentioned that Jibreel came to Abraham, where it says Jibreel came to Abraham
in Quran.
Yeah, nowhere
in Quran.
Okay, nowhere, right?
In Quran, I said to you, not clear.
All right,
that,
not clear. It's just said it never mentioned. Let me ask you, is it true that Jibreel, he came to Muhammad as a man?
In the first, in the beginning,
it doesn't matter. Did he came to him as a man? Hello.
Sometimes.
Say again, please.
Hello.
Did Jibreel came to Muhammad as a man?
Yes, sometimes Jibreel come to Muhammad as a man.
All right. And how come in the same chapter then? How come in the same chapter we are reading from here? If we go to verse number 9, it says Allah will not send an angel as a man because that will cause confusion. If you read here, it says, if we had made it an angel, we should have sent him as a man, and we should certainly have called them confusion in the matter which they have already covered with confusion. What does that mean? Explain to us.
ولو جعلناه ملكا لجعلناه رجلا وللبسنا عليهم ما يلبسون. This is what you.
Okay. So if Allah want to send, if Allah want to send angels, He will send them only as men.
Yes.
But now, okay, hold on. But this is a contradiction because you said to me a second ago that
yes,
Muhammad,
that
Muhammad,
and
we receive angels who come in the image of angels.
Angel. Yes, if and if we had made him an angel, we would have made him appear as a man, and we would have covered them with that which they covered themselves.
What does that mean? My friend, if Allah want to send an angel, He will send him as in the shape of what? Confirm to me, please.
This is about that unbelief. Ask Muhammad to send a prophet as an angel, not as a man. God said that if He send a prophet as from angel, He will also come like a man, because they don't see the angel in the original picture. So He said, if him an angel, we would have made him appear as a man.
Okay, so if Allah want to send an angel, always He will come as a man, correct? That's what the verse saying.
Yeah.
Okay, so how you say to me that Jibreel, he came to Muhammad, you know, not always as an angel, not always as a man, sorry.
I said, you know, Jibreel come as a man to the Prophet Muhammad, and when Hadith said that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam see the Jibreel in the original picture.
Okay, but this verse here saying, if Allah want to send Jibreel, He will send him as a man. How Jibreel came to him in that, not in the image of a man? This is contradiction. Which one is the one is correct one? If we will send him an angel, we will send him as a man. You are the one who said that to me. Okay, so how Jibreel he saw,
yes,
been seen by Muhammad, but not as a man, as an angel with 600 wings.
My friend, this is this verse talk about the people, the ordinary people, not talk about prophet or
who is the ordinary people who saw angels.
Abusar.
Where do you get this from?
This ayah.
Okay, where is the angels who appear to normal people, like who in the Quran? Where does the angels appear to normal people?
This ayah, this the first ayah in 8, ولو وقالوا لولا أنزل عليه ملك ولو أنزلنا ملكا لقضي الأمر ثم لا ينظرون.
Okay, so now he's saying that the people they are asking him why he don't send him an angel so we can see him, right?
Yes.
Okay, and Allah saying to them, if I send an angel, I will send him as a man, correct?
وقالوا لولا أنزل عليه ملك ولو أنزلناه ملكا لقضي الأمر.
Who is the one who saw the angels speaking to Muhammad? According to the book of Imtihan al-Wahi, it says that Khadija, Muhammad, he told her that he sees someone in his room. Is that correct? He sees someone in his room.
Yes.
All right. Muhammad did not say he looked like an angel. He saw some. He sees someone. Obviously, he looked like a man. All right. So now, Jibreel is not cannot be seen by anyone except by Muhammad, based on this story. His wife, she is in the same room, but she cannot see him. Do you agree?
Again.
Okay, my friend, please. Khadija, there's a chapter, it's called Imtihan al-Wahi, where the angel came to supposedly to Muhammad, but he don't speak to him. He sit in his bedroom. Muhammad, he told his wife that there is a person who come to him, but he didn't talk. And he is not sure if he is an angel or not. Khadija, she said, when your friend come, and this is what she call him in Arabic, she says sahibuka, sahibuka, the one who accompany you, your friend who come to you, if he come to you, let me know. So when he come to him, Muhammad, he told Khadija, I see him now, he's here. Khadija, she asked him, you know the story, she to sit in the top of her right leg, her left leg, and then to sit in the top of her, and then to take off the clothes, and then supposedly the one who Muhammad he see, he left the room. This is what they call the examination of al-wahi, of inspiration. I'm sure you know the story, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Now, why Khadija, she is not able to see the angel, only Muhammad?
Because this angel come to Muhammad only, not come to.
But the verse says, "But you are the one who said to me that the angels they appear as men for normal people." But Muhammad, he did not see; he see him as an angel, as a man, and that means he have a physical being. So how you cannot see a man? If he is a man, how I am a man, in full shape of a man, but yet only Muhammad can see me.
I don't understand you.
Well, I am a man now. Jibreel, he became a man. All right? Jibreel, he became a man. Okay. Now, Muhammad, he can see this man. But, you know, Khadija, she cannot see this man. How this happened?
Jibreel, he also in I don't sure that he come by a man in this story, in this hadith, not he come a man.
What this hadith, so not, so what he saw, what he saw
us that,
okay, what he saw, what he saw, what Muhammad he saw, the one in the room, who what he saw an angel.
Yes, he
so
saw,
if
an
he saw
angel,
an angel, why he how, why he did not how, recognize him as an angel, why he's confused, the angel he will look like an angel. Why he is not sure if he is the devil or he is an angel? I mean, what the point? Do he look like so ugly? Do he look like a man, normal man, so he's confused what he is? Or he look like an angel who's amazing look? I mean, do we see angels always? I mean, isn't it obvious how the angels look like based on descriptions of religion? So how Muhammad could not recognize if this is an angel or not, but yet his wife, by doing striptease, she was able to recognize? Do you think in this point, Muhammad was imagining things not true?
Yes, it is a true hadith.
I know, but I'm saying, do you think maybe Muhammad, he is imagining there is somebody there, but there's nobody there?
The angel, when come to the prophet, the prophet, he say, this angel, only, not the people say this angel. This is what happened.
Khadija, based on the story, Khadija, my friend, she never saw it. Khadija, she never saw the angel.
He didn't see the angel.
Let me ask you, is it true that Muhammad, he said that when he walked in the street, he heard the stone saying to him, Assalamu alaikum?
The angel?
No, Muhammad, he said that when he walked in the street, the stones, they say to him, Assalamu alaikum.
This is the not true hadith.
Not true.
Yes.
What does that mean, not true?
And the stone not said to him, Assalamu alaikum. I don't, but the there is another hadith that an جزء النخلة سلم عليه أو عندما كان يخطب أما الحجر. This is not hadith, I think.
Okay. Well, according to the hadith, it says, and I don't know why you are saying, you are the one who said to me the hadith about Abraham, it's coming from Ibn Ishaq. Sorry, that the hadith about Muhammad is coming from Ibn Ishaq, where it says that the angel Jibreel, he told him, I am Jibreel, correct? The same hadith is coming from Ibn Ishaq. So why this one is accepted by you, that one is not accepted? What happened?
What this hadith says? Please read
the one who report the story. The one who report the story that the stones and the rocks, they greet Muhammad. They say to him, Assalamu alaikum. Is Ibn Ishaq. The same hadith is coming from Ibn Ishaq. The one you told me, it's a true. How Ibn Ishaq, the same reporter, one you like his story, you say it is true, and the other one you don't like his hadith, so you say it's not true. Which one is true?
Not all hadith come by Ibn Ishaq is true. Not all hadith. If the
so
hadith
Ibn,
come
so Ibn, Ibn Ishaq, he lies sometimes. Sometimes he's honest.
Maybe he wrong. Not I don't sure that he lie, but he wrong. He hear
okay,
from
you,
the
my, no problem.
Narrator.
Okay, you said that the trees they say to Muhammad Assalamu alaikum. Is that correct?
Yeah, I don't sure of this.
You are not sure.
Because
but you said it's sahih a second ago.
Because this is a hadith not come in Bukhari, but in the Ibn Ishaq, in the.
But you said it's sahih. I asked you. You said it's sahih. You said it's sahih. In front of me, I have a hadith that says from Jami' al-Tirmidhi that the mountains and the trees they say to Muhammad, peace upon you, Muhammad, and this is a sahih hadith. Do you agree with it?
If this hadith come in a Sunnah's books,
this is Sunnah books. Obviously, this is not Shia books.
Yes, yes, I know.
Okay.
I mean that in Sunnah's books, not Sirah. There is a difference between Sunnah and Sirah.
No problem.
Not all hadith in Sirah is true.
My friend, do you agree with it or not? That Muhammad, he hear trees and mountains and rocks greeting him.
Yes, what? But yes.
Okay. So yes, okay, that's what I want. So yes, guys, listen to this. Do you think that Muhammad here is mentally ill? Is it normal? I mean, why stones are saying to Muhammad, Assalamu alaikum? Is it stones alive? Are they creatures who they are alive? They have like a heart and blood and they have a tongue. Stones saying to Muhammad, a tree saying to Muhammad, Assalamu alaikum? A camel saying to Muhammad, Assalamu alaikum? Rocks in the street, they say to Muhammad, Assalamu alaikum, and nobody hear that except Muhammad. Don't you think Muhammad, he have a mental illness? He hear voices, not true?
He not necessarily hear a voice from stone, but he maybe he understand a sign that tell
this is not what the story says. It doesn't say a sign, my friend. It doesn't say a sign. It says, Assalamu alaikum, Prophet. They speak to him even in Arabic. The Prophet, he speak only one language, not Persian, not Aramaic, he speak only Arabic. According to Muslim, he do not even know how to write, how to read. And now we see that the stones and rocks and mountains and hills and trees, they say to him, Assalamu alaikum, Prophet, but nobody hear that except him. Isn't it, this is obvious for you as a Muslim? He will go. He saw an angel. Nobody see him except him and his wife. She is in this next in the same room. And then what the wife she do? She asked him to sit in the top of her to examine if this is an angel or not. So there's no proof Muhammad is a prophet. When the angel came to Muhammad in the cave, anyone saw the angel? No. Anyone was a witness? No. There's no witness for anything. Muhammad hearing stone saying to him, "Assalamu alaikum." Nobody hear it. When Muhammad he received the chapter of Al-Fatiha, you remember Al-Fatiha, right?
Yes.
Okay. Is it true that Muhammad he received the chapter of Al-Fatiha each time he wanna go out to the bathroom at night? The angel Jibreel he come to him, and he don't say I am Jibreel. He said to him, Muhammad, and Muhammad he run away.
No. Not
okay. Let us see if this is true or not. Here we go. I'm going to show it in the screen so everybody can see with me what I'm talking about. You are saying you say it's not true, and later you take it back and you say it's true. Let us see if this time you will do the same. We go to the tafsir. Now we'll put it in the screen so everybody can see with me what I'm going to show on the screen. Give me a second. Here we go. All right. Tafsir. This is a chapter of Al-Fatiha. And this is the book of Asbab al-Nuzul. It says here, whenever the Prophet he went out, he used to hear someone calling him, "Oh Muhammad." And whenever he heard this, he used to flee. Do you see it, Dr. Rohi? This is the book of Asbab al-Nuzul. This is the official website of the King of Jordan. It's an official government website. The angel, the one you call him an angel, Muhammad, when he hear his voice, he run away. And he come to him only when Muhammad, he want to go to the bathroom. And not only that, he say to him, "Oh Muhammad." And then Muhammad he run, and then Muhammad he walk. He, after he running many time, because each time he wanna go out, this voice come to him and say, "Oh Muhammad," and he flee. Then Waraqa, after Muhammad told him the story, Waraqa ibn Nawfal advised him as usual. Waraqa is the advisor of Muhammad. He is the true prophet. He advised him to remain in his place, and he told him, "Next time you see him, remain in your place. So when the caller calls him again, so you can hear what he wants to tell you." And this is what the Prophet he did. And then when the caller called him again, "Oh Muhammad," he said, "Here I am." Muhammad said, "Here I am at your service." The caller said, "I say bear witness that there is no God but Allah, and I bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah." The angel is converting to Islam, my friend. I mean, what is this?
Okay, my friend, as to Asbab al-Nuzul, not all Asbab al-Nuzul, yani revelations, causes, the truth. Sometimes revelations, causes wasn't true, because some Muslims, when Allah was, yani reveals new Quran to the Prophet, they were thinking that the Quran revealed for some reason. Why? Because every Muslim was so afraid that the first maybe suggested to him, or this first means him, so he was check out his مثلاً, act 2 days ago, and no, and so he want to search was a reason, but not all asbab al-nuzul is true. Let's
make it simple. Not all Asbab al-Nuzul is true. Not all Ibn Ishaq is true. Not all Sahih al-Bukhari is true. Not all what Dr. Rohi he say is true. I mean, who are you? Who are you, with my respect to you, Dr. Rohi, to say to the one who is a biggest scholar in Islam, to the point they have his books in their and to teach Muslims about what's happening, what is behind the verses, you are telling this guy who is a big shot in Islam he is wrong? I mean, how he became wrong and you became right?
We know, my friend.
What do you know? How you know? How you know? Who is the one? Who is the one who decide that this scholar is a liar? Are you saying he's a liar? Are you saying he's a liar? Are you saying he's a liar?
I will tell you. In Tafsir's book, there is a lot of saying about revelations, causes, or asbab al-nuzul, but in the end, we find this is a false causes. The question here, why the interpreters wrote this in their books?
Okay, why?
It is for my, yani, it is for many reasons, like as honesty to write everything that they was hearing. Maybe this is true. Also, some of them like to getting beat scoop, as the press doing in this present days. Also causes to difference in ideology that making some narrators to take some opinions and leave some. Also, some of explainers liking to write strange things in their books to make their books more exciting. Also,
okay, maybe Muhammad too, and maybe you Muslims, you just said something very important, Dr. Rohi, that you Muslims, you fabricate stories about your prophet to make your books exciting and to make Muhammad exciting person. Is that what you are saying to me? Guys, did you hear what Dr. Rohi said? We Muslims, and he's talking about Muslim scholars, not anyone, not Abdul, he is opening a channel on YouTube, big names. They fabricate stories about the prophet in order to make their books exciting and to make you excited about the prophet. So now what you are saying to us, that all Islamic source is just fabricated books and there's no resource of it and there's no proof of it. And you Muslims, you have to guess. This is what you are saying. You said we have to guess how you decide that this story is a lie. Can you tell me? How you, with your PhD in Islam, how you were able to find in a second that this story is a lie?
Listen, my friend, listen to me. Because if not one of tafsir explainer not understanding some verses which carried some narrators to fabricated revelations causes from themselves.
Give me some names of fabricators additional to this guy Al-Wahidi. Who is the names of fabricators? Like, do you accept Ibn Kathir?
Yes.
Is Ibn Kathir, for example, forget about Al-Suddi. Do you think Ibn Kathir is a fabricator?
No, not Al-Qurtubi. Ibn Kathir. Listen, not the Mufassir, but the narrator that he tell the Mufassir that stories.
Okay, shouldn't the one who do interpretation?
For example,
my friend, if I am now trying to present to you what is the reason for this verse came down, if I present for you false reason, it's mean I am false too, because I should make a decision before I write if this is a story is valid or not. So obviously the narrator and the guy who wrote this book, they are in total agreement that this story is true. Otherwise he will not put it down, and he will not say each time the prophet, he is not even giving interpretation for the verse. He did not. This is not about interpretation. He is saying what happened. Each time the prophet, he want to get out to the bathroom, he hear a voice. It says, "Oh Muhammad." And then Muhammad, he go crazy and he start running. And then the voice keep chasing him, and Muhammad, he keep running until he hear it no more. Every night, until Waraq ibn Nawfal advise him to tell and told him, don't do that. Next time you hear this voice, stay in your place. Okay, I want you to show me one Muslim scholar agree with you that this story is fabrication. Do you have anyone? Do you know anyone? Any scholar who said this story here is a lie?
Can you tell me the story by Arabic, please? This hadith.
I have it in front of me in English. You can go to the book of Asbab al-Nuzul. You know, you I'm sure you have a big library. Go to the book of Asbab al-Nuzul. This will be in the beginning, because this is a chapter of Al-Fatiha, verse number one, in the beginning.
Let me to search about this hadith and see, but I am sure that is not the true hadith. I am sure that it's not true hadith.
You are sure, but you remember last time you told me about something you are not, you are sure, and later you came back the second day or a few days after you told me you are wrong, it was sahih, right?
Because in the not all hadith and asbab al-nuzul is true, I told you before, but in if they, this come of this hadith in the books of tafsir, books of sunnah, it is a different way, it is different yani, situation.
Okay, you know what, I will give you time to find this hadith, maybe even you can call me next time we will do this thing. But however, let us go back to see if Muhammad really is a prophet or not. You agree that Muhammad, he received and he heard voices, and he hears stones saying to him, As-salamu alaykum, mountains saying to him, As-salamu alaykum, trees, they speak to him. And nobody hear that. And even you say the camel, he spoke to him. Is that correct? Is that true?
Can you read the hadith by Arabic, please?
Okay. As an example, here the hadith says, كنت مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بمكة فخرجنا في بعض نواحيها فمستقبله جبر ولا شجر إلا وهو يقول السلام عليك يا رسول الله. What do you think about this hadith?
خرجنا في بعض نواحيها. This hadith is not in the books of Sunnah.
This is in Jami' al-Tirmidhi. This is Sunnah.
So, I search for hadith. I don't find this hadith, my friend.
It's in front of me. Anyway, no problem, no problem. No problem. Let me ask you. When the angel, he said to Muhammad, something nobody here except him. And when the angel appeared to Muhammad, nobody saw except him.
Yes, I found this hadith.
Okay.
يقول كنت مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بمكة فخرجنا في بعض نواحيها فما استقبله جبل ولا شجر إلا يقول السلام عليكم.
Right.
Look at this hadith in the bottom. This wrote ضعيف.
ضعيف. What ضعيف?
Weak hadith.
Is ضعيف is accepted or rejected? Is ضعيف accepted or rejected?
Rejected.
No, my friend, who taught you that? You have a PhD in Islam. Da'if hadith, da'if hadith, Dr. Rohi, listen.
Strange hadith.
Listen, my friend. Da'if hadith is not rejected. It's not rejected. Da'if, it is a hadith which is accepted, and the rank of it is da'if, which means that we don't have enough proof to make it in higher rank, but it's not rejected. I never heard of a single Muslim scholar, he said that hadith, da'if, is rejected. Since when?
Yes, not to take da'if hadith in the يعني, aqa'id, but take in the fada'il al-a'mal, they take da'if, but this hadith not true as to me.
Okay, but you agreed, you said there's a different hadith that the trees spoke to Muhammad, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.
This hadith, yes.
Now, why the trees are speaking to Muhammad and what for? I mean, what is the trees are living creature who they can talk? Is that like the one we see in the cartoon where the trees speak? This tree have a tongue and have a mouth and is speaking? What does tree say? What the tree say to Muhammad, if you don't mind to say to us?
سواء لحظة خرجنا في بعضنا وحيها. I was with the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in Mecca. We departed to one its supports and no mountain or trees was before him except that he said.
I lost you, Dr. Rohi. Did you drop your call? He is still with me, but I hear nothing. Say again, please. I did not hear you because I lost you.
The hadith narrated Ali ibn Abi Talib, I was with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Mecca. We departed to one of the suburbs and no mountain or trees was before him except that it says, peace be upon him, O Messenger of Allah. Great Daif, al-Hadith, Daif.
So it's Daif.
In this Hadith.
So yes. Now we come to a conclusion that the Hadith you told me, it is Sahih, has 5 minutes ago, now it is Daif. Okay, that's wonderful. Now, do your Prophet really, in any story you believe is true? Because you said you believe in that. But now you are saying it's Daif. Do you really believe that in any occasion Muhammad was able to communicate with rocks or stones or trees or animals? Yes or no?
As me, this is this hadith daif, and not I take this hadith as a true.
So you don't believe Muhammad, he spoke to any animals or any trees or any rocks?
If Allah want to the trees speak to him, he will make the trees speak to
him. That's another question. The question, do you believe really that Muhammad, he spoke to
while we not read this in this strong hadith, we don't believe in this.
Okay, hold on. Do your Prophet hear sounds and voices which is strange?
Again, please. I miss you.
How your Prophet he used to hear the inspiration of Allah?
Inspiration of Allah by the Jibril.
How Jibril he talk?
Know how we talk, but we don't know. All the human don't know how the angel talk, but
do he talk to him in his language, the Quran? What do you mean you do not know? The Quran says we never send a messenger except in the language of the tongue of his people. So obviously you will speak to the messenger in the tongue of his own. So Jibreel, he spoke to Muhammad in Arabic, or he spoke to him in different language or different communication way? What is the way Jibreel he used when he communicated with Muhammad?
Sure, in Arabic.
In Arabic. Okay. Did your Prophet receive inspiration in music?
I don't know. In music, okay. Not. No. But
either you say yes or no. I mean, what do you mean no? You said in Arabic. And did he
as a bell.
That's wonderful. How Muhammad was able to translate the sound of a bell? He received sound of a bell, right? How Muhammad translate that to Arabic Quran?
Not all the revelation as a pill, but the beginning of the revelation as a pill, as you.
My friend, doesn't matter.
You hear a pill, then you speak to the person.
Wonderful. Muhammad, now let us say you are now in front of Muhammad. Muhammad, you receive a revelation in the sound of a bell. How Muhammad? He hear the bell and then he speak the Quran in Arabic, translating what the bell sound is. Bell is not Arabic language, it's a bell. How Muhammad translate the inspiration of his God from the bell sound to Arabic? How is that? And why Allah giving him the sound of the inspiration in as a bell?
Okay, my friend, now maybe we discuss another time, because we don't prepare myself.
No problem.
Inshallah, we call you and message me when you يعني, busy. We debate another time, inshallah.
No problem. But my, before you go, Mr. Rohi, Dr. Rohi, you see, Muhammad himself, he said that the sound of the bell is a musical instrument of shaitan. And you just agreed that Muhammad, and you are the one who told me that Muhammad, he received his inspiration in the sound of a bell. That means you are confirming that Muhammad was receiving his musical instrument of shaitan, and he claimed yet that this is Quran. Now you said you are not prepared for that. I will give you as many days as you wish to prepare, and you are more than welcome to call me time anytime, Dr. Rohi. I'm happy to have you again, and thank you for being with us. And I hope that you will come next time with better answers, and you will be prepared for what we stop with. And the next time you call me, we will start from here again. All right?
Inshallah. Inshallah. Okay. Thank you, my friend. Good night. Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum salam. All right. Well, as usual, when things get hot, I am not prepared. Because now we are arriving to the conclusion that Muhammad hears voices, and those voices are crazy. The guy is a crazy guy. I mean, isn't it obvious? So what we do? Okay, now actually I should go, because now this guy have a PhD in Islam. He's a big sheikh. And now I got to go.